Please be seated. Well, good afternoon and a very warm welcome to the University of Plymouth. My name is Professor David Moore. I'm Deputy Vice-Chancellor of the University. And we gather together today for a very special and very happy event. But this week also began on a different note, following the death of Her Majesty the Queen. And the University acknowledges and gives thanks for her dedication, selfless sacrifice and love over the last 70 years. I'm sure we offer our sympathy and support to His Majesty King Charles III, members of the royal family, what continues, I'm sure, to be a difficult time. Well, it's my privilege and pleasure to welcome you to this special University of Plymouth graduation for the class of 2020, and to declare open this ceremony for the conferment of awards. So I'd now like to invite Professor Shubhi Banerjee, Executive Dean of the Faculty of Health, to address the congregation. Shubhi.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Deputy Vice-Chancellor. Distinguished guests, relatives and supporters, and graduates of 2020. As the Deputy Vice-Chancellor said, I'm Shubhi Banerjee, and today we are here to celebrate the success of you. You are incredible 2020 cohort. Whether you studied in the Faculty of Health or of Arts and Humanity and Business, you really did study at the most difficult time you could possibly study, and you did brilliantly. It's my great pleasure to welcome you to the University of Plymouth's graduation ceremony. As the Dean of my faculty, I have been totally inspired by your hard work and your achievements over the time that you were at the university. You studied, as I said, through the most complex of times. Everything changed, and then everything changed again. And then suddenly everything changed, and you responded. You responded with creativity and with real resilience. But most importantly, you supported each other through the pandemic. Thank you. Thank you very much. And whether you've gone straight into work or whether you're going back into study or whether you're taking some time to decide on your career, please know that we, the university, are very, very proud of you and your achievements. And as you reflect on those achievements, allow me perhaps to give a brief glimpse into some of what's been happening at your university and what continues to make our work in health and in business so very special. Many of the staff who taught you have been recognised nationally for their expertise, from roles in bodies, national bodies, external bodies, teaching awards, to influencing government policy. In the medical school, our research is addressing some of the most pressing issues in society today, from Parkinson's to food poverty, from brain tumours to refugee support. And in the School of Biomedical Sciences, the faculty there continue to make significant contributions to antimicrobial resistance research and to the public awareness of the real challenges that the fact that antibiotics that we commonly use are starting not to work in important conditions. Dr. Tina Joshi took part in a discussion panel with the former chief medical officer at Oxford in May, and she was invited to the House of Lords to celebrate her significant contribution to the field. She was also highly commended in the Asian Women of Achievement Awards in June for this work. The school has recently started collaborating with the Army Engagement Group at Sandhurst and our local University Officers Training Corps and the Royal Naval Units, with the aim to highlight career opportunities in the armed forces for our students and to facilitate the move to university life for ex-armed forces personnel, we have several projects underway seeking to enhance skills and careers. And in business, our Centre for Coastal Communities submitted evidence to two key government inquiries on placemaking and the levelling up agenda, and is to co-produce a policy-relevant classification that facilitates a better understanding of the diverse challenges that England's coastal communities are facing. Now, as we celebrate your achievements, I think we should take advantage of the fact that we're here in person to thank those people that helped you along the way. Our teaching staff, who guided you through your academic career. Your family and friends have also encouraged you, offering emotional support, practical support, and often financial support as well. On your behalf, I would like to pay tribute and recognize all of these people and say a very big and very public thank you to them all. I certainly think all that support's worth a round of applause, so thank you for that. Now, as you move forward in your life and in your career, I want to assure you that our support will continue. You still have access to our Careers and Employability Service, and our alumni network is there to help you stay in touch with students in the UK and abroad, in your own course and in others. And you also have the opportunity to share your career insights with your successors as part of our mentoring scheme. And all of this is on the alumni community part of the website. So in your career, in the long career ahead of you, or careers for some of you, all sorts of unexpected challenges and unexpected opportunities will be thrown at you. And the fundamental understandings and the values that we've built together with you here in Plymouth will enable you to meet those challenges and to take advantage of those opportunities. And those are values of honesty, of integrity, of trustworthiness, of compassion, and of conscientiousness. The value of service to others is what you've learnt at Plymouth. And just now it's difficult to predict what will happen next week, let alone next year. But one thing that we can predict is that healthcare and the world of business is changing and will continue to change massively in the decades ahead when you are in work. Our systems need to adapt to respond to new challenges like COVID, but also larger challenges of population aging, of technology, of scientific innovation, and whatever else is around the corner. And now, more than ever, society needs you to deliver not only technical brilliance, but a human, a pragmatic, a responsible personal response, whatever your job is, be it in healthcare or business or in other places. And Plymouth has prepared you to do just that. So please have the courage to follow your heart as well as your head and to trust your intuition. Your intuition is your values talking to you. But most importantly, enjoy what you do. Because yours is a bright, important future, and we wish you all the very best in all you do. Be proud. Be proud and celebrate your achievements today. Move forward with confidence that you are prepared, and have fun. So, thank you. We will now start the conferment of awards.
We now commence the conferment of awards. Deputy Vice Chancellor, I have the honour of presenting the following students from Plymouth Business School. Bachelor of Arts, Accounting and Finance, Victoria Alden. Asena Askin. Adam Blything. Sophie Brown. Thomas Fort. Valencia Gracia. Lloyd Hancock. Daniel Hartley. Andrew Haste. Ryan Kent. Victoria Maggs. Leah Morris. Also awarded the Francis Clark Prize for the best BA Accounting and Finance student, Amelia Tomkin. Anna Villalba. Lauren Whitney. Alexia Woodgate. Samuel Wyborn. Bachelor of Arts Business, Carrie-Anne Anstis. Lucy Barnes. James Buchanan. Thomas Burbridge. Jake Cooper. Abigail Cookson. Also awarded the Plymouth Business School Prize for the best business administration student, Plymouth Campus, Darcy Downs. Sophie Ecclesall. Thomas Godley. Alfie Hardy. Charlie Hendon. Brunette Kasongo. Paige Lawson. Rowan Leeton. Sarah Marchant. Jack McConaughey. Megan McKinley. Emily Poe. Also awarded the Plymouth Business School Prize for the Best Business Student Research Paper, Georgia Reeve. Olivia Riddles. Ashley Wilson. Bachelor of Science, Business Management, Georgina Ackerman. Abigail Bassey. Will Buxton. Jordan Caff. Harry Kahn. Oliver Conway. Claire Cooper. Alexandra Crook. Jeremy Dallas. Joe Derbyshire. Adrian Dinham. Benjamin Harding. William Ingleby. Emily James. Tobin Lee. James McDonald. Callum Miller. Dylan Nurse. Kane Nurse. Laura Ugden. Jack Parry. Tegan Phillips. Bradley Smith. Jamie Tan. Thomas Thompson. Liliane Wu-Umimana. Harry Wilkins. Bachelor of Science, Business Management, International Management, Francesca Dunford. Ricardo Eric Peng. Adrian Kowalski. Nathania Tala. Brittany Barkle. Abby Buchan. Samuel Bussell. Stephen Cross. Thomas Evans. Paige Kernley. James Lobb. Emily Matthews. Andre Catalin Radu. Emily Smith. Ella Spicer. Alice Thornhill. Olivia Towner. Bachelor of Science, Business Management, Leadership, Noah Gilbert. Ellis Saksak. Bachelor of Science, Business Economics, Emily Collins. Also awarded the Plymouth Business School Prize for the best overall economics performance, Peter Jenkins. Edward Logan. Comfort Malodi. Alexander Reynolds. Bachelor of Science Economics Programme, Jonathan Hadida. Jacob Howe. Billy Jepson. Oliver King. Ella Lambert. Benjamin Lord. Cassandra Mashanda. Anissa Mohammed. Anna Nwagwu. Samuel Pinker. Nathan Sleet. Ryan Smith. Bachelor of Science, Financial Economics, Mustafa Chowdhury. Callum Levy. Bachelor of Arts, International Business Programme, Holly Charles. Oscar Griffiths. William Hain. Ellen Johnson. Eleanor Jones. Laura Lavazzi. Charlotte Weldon. Also awarded the Gordon Smith Memorial Prize for the best dissertation by an international business student, Megan Whitby. Bachelor of Arts, International Management, Grace Wan. Bachelor of Arts, Human Resource Management, Gabriella Lavender. Bachelor of Science, Management Practice, Harriet Pryor. Bachelor of Science, Management Practice, International Trade, Jennifer Kass. Maria Estrada Alonso. Bachelor of Science, Management Practice, Leadership and Human Resource Management, Matthew McAuliffe. Shona Young. Bachelor of Science, Marketing, Sophie Ahmed. Emily Ashton. Amy Butterworth. Amy Carey. Ashley Farr. Beatrice Haywood. Also awarded the Chartered Institute of Marketing Prize for the best BSc marketing student, Stephanie Jasper. Ross McMullen. Oliver Millwood. Percy Orasio. Nathan Peters. Loxie. Nathan Thompson. Rachel Wood. Simon Young. Diploma of Higher Education, Kaylee Nelligan. Bachelor of Science, Cruise Management, Harriet Corkwell. Charlotte Maskant. Alice Perks. Bachelor of Science, Event Management, Amy Allen. Tara Dale. Iona Easton. Natasha Felton. Shannon Hartle. Also awarded the School of Tourism and Hospitality Prize for the best placement student, Amy Holgate. Jodie Ingham. Katie Jones. Thomas Lehow. Emma Murgatroyd. Bethany Newman. Alice Peters. Gemma Rothwell. Also awarded the Prague Eventry Outstanding Events Management graduate, Hannah Russell Yard. Phoebe Scammell. Rebecca Sluman. Nicole Stewart. Nadine Thring. Megan Williams. Bachelor of Science, Hospitality Management, Charlotte Cross. Emma Hayward. Amy Spink. Bachelor of Arts, Hospitality, Tourism and Event Management, Rose Manser. Bachelor of Science, Tourism Management, Shannon Bedlam. Jade Britton. Emily Finch. Karis Lang. Also awarded the John Brockman Memorial Prize for the Best Honours Project, Stevie Maher. Nicole Tarter. Emmy Vinnis. Olivia White. Bachelor of Science, International Hospitality Management, Eleanor Oakley. Bachelor of Science, Business and Tourism, Jessica M. Bachelor of Science, International Tourism Management, Karima Ahmed. Timia Albert. Tegan Bold. Tyler Cahill. Yvonne De Vera. Zainab Elam Hamdi. Also awarded the John Fowler Holidays Prize for the tourism student with the highest overall marks, Georgia Francis. Melissa Hansen. Jessica Hobbs. Evelina Popiel. Joe Thompson. Jessica Wilcox. Taif Uz Zaman. Bachelor of Science, Tourism and Hospitality Management, Amy Eglishaw. Bryony Hunt. Tatiana Panoska. Jessica Scully. Jonathan Tai. Bachelor of Science, International Supply Chain and Shipping Management, Mohammed Noor Akmar Shah. Bachelor of Arts, International Trade and Operations Management, Elizabeth Hall. Janine Lizard. Mila Verma. Ben Webb. William Marriott. Mohammed Ali. Noor Mohammed Ali. Z Teo. Yu Teo. Bachelor of Science, Maritime Business and Maritime Law, Ku Fabian. Megan Merrick. Amiruddin Mohammed Abdullah. Douglas Oakes. Riggs Umar. Christopher Roberts. Jaihui Wang. Bachelor of Science, Maritime Transport and Logistics, G. Giorgio Lentini. Apna Somachandra. Nufatin Siduman. Ira Sumami. Kuteri Izanal Abidin. Master of Science, Business and Management, K. Domk. Yan Fayin. Nico Zelligan. Master of Science, Business and Management, Finance, Philip Lanzen. Luca Lichtenfeld. Lydia Sokorab. Master of Science, Business and Management, Operations and Global Supply Chains, Alex Mulani. Tunutenda Tom Bindo. Master of Science, Digital and Social Media Marketing, Florence Boner. Charles Carter. Daniel Daly. Master of Science, International Shipping, Efstathios Camilleris. Davida Siviero. Andrea Vella. Master of Science, Tourism and Hospitality Management, Samia Kofians. Kimberly Turner. Master of Business Administration, Naveed Matloub. Master of Science, Finance, Victor Solomonidis. Master of Arts, Human Resource Management, Joanne Cucci. Thomas Clements. Joshua Cliff. Jack Henniker. Leo Long. Megan Newstead. Rebecca Robinson. Master of Science, International Business, Fawzia Ahmed. Akinteo Akinrinsola. Master of Science, International Logistics and Supply Chain Management, Rodrigo Javara Rios. Yen Swan Ho. Master of Science, International Procurement and Supply Chain Management, Gies de Witt. Deputy Vice-Chancellor, I have the honour of presenting the following doctorate awards from Plymouth Business School. Doctor of Philosophy, having undertaken a programme of research in the study explores the resilience of entrepreneurs in Afghanistan, Iraq and Palestine, Doa Athilathini. Doctor of Philosophy, having undertaken a programme of research in Saudi etiquettes, herding, the role of regional and global factors, Dina Gabori. Doctor of Philosophy, having undertaken a programme of research in the promotion of innovation in the EU marine equipment sector, Mohammed Hassanuddin. Doctor of Philosophy, having undertaken a programme of research in psychological well-being and the charitable bequest decision, Lucy Lothian. Doctor of Philosophy, having undertaken a programme of research in study of microfinance institutions and their impact on the society of Bangladesh, Abim Mustafa. Doctor of Philosophy, having undertaken a programme of research in how power and control drive behaviour and identity, modification among cruise ship workers, a qualitative study, Richard Parkman. Doctor of Philosophy, having undertaken a programme of research in financial economics of the shadow banking sector in the provision of safe monetary assets in the UK, Dominic Silman. Doctor of Philosophy, having undertaken a programme of research in the transforming organisations into entrepreneurial communities, how can understanding the constructions of organisational agents and the experience of human resource management enable SMEs to sustain strategic entrepreneurship? James Smith. Doctor of Philosophy, having undertaken a programme of research in workplace coaching and mental well-being, Alison Sydenham. Doctor of Philosophy, having undertaken a programme of research in exploring lifestyle entrepreneurship within lifestyle sports, Laura Wallace. Doctor of Philosophy, having undertaken a programme of research in international hotel chains operations in China, employee motivation, job performance and satisfaction, Jim Wazang.
Deputy Vice Chancellor, I have the honour of presenting the following students from the School of Biomedical Sciences. Bachelor of Science, Biomedical Science, also awarded BSc Hons Biomedical Science Academic Excellence Award, Highest Achiever, Year 3, and the BSc Hons Biomedical Science Research Excellence Award, Highest Achiever in Research Project, Year 3, Meryl Ahmed. Olivia Anstey. Celine Basso. Hannah Campbell. David Compton. Alexandra Gibbs. Paniota Konstantinidou. Joseph Cooper. Charlotte Crutchlow. Nelly Dalpadarugue Fernando. Katie Dye. Tegan Edwards. Matthew Fendulkley. Saranika Ganasthanas. Matthew Goldsack. Gwen Gravel. Ben Heath. Yay! Amy Hodder. Danielle Jones. Olivia Jones. Sophia Jones. Nitya Kamarvel. Ravina Mawaha. Nikita Mildren. Emily Newson. Lauren Peel. Thanthri Peris. Sharon Sabu. Amber Short. Susanna Sanaki. Ross Spicer. Lucy Streeter. Bitharan Verathayan. Madeline Watkins. Jessica Wilkins. Abena Yeboah. Yugaso Yusuf. Yvette Zoma. Bachelor of Science, Human Biosciences, Farah Al Hadid. Kate Ashton. Anna Chambers. Emily Chown. Ojuriaki Edizode. Kira Harding. Toby Huxtable. Claudia Kirby. Natalie Osborne. Also awarded the BSc Hons Human Biosciences Academic Excellence Award, Highest Achiever Year 3, Emily Schenk. Also awarded the BSc Hons Human Biosciences Research Excellence Award, Highest Achiever in Research Project Year 3, Owen Stone. Bachelor of Science, Nutrition, Exercise and Health, Olivia Barnes. Hamina Bulstrode. Stephanie Ellis. Jason Massos. Stephanie Ng. Natasha Seeley. Yu Ung. Isabel Webb. David Wymond. Bachelor of Science, Healthcare Science, Cardiac Physiology, Madeline Clegg. Ria Queno. Also awarded the BSc Hons Healthcare Science Physiology Research Excellence Award, Highest Achiever in Research Project Year 3, Fatima De Osero. Alan Ellis. Bethany Marker. Thomas O'Keefe. Kaylee Slocum. Bachelor of Science, Healthcare Science, Infection Science, Kira Coggings. Master of Science, Biomedical Science, Cancer Biology. Also awarded the MSc Biomedical Sciences Highest Achiever Taught Element, Alicia Herbert. Master of Science, Biomedical Science, Infection and Immunity, Kalilu Donzo. Rita Lopez da Costa Marquez Pinto.
Deputy Vice-Chancellor, I have the honour of presenting the following students from the Peninsula Medical School. Bachelor of Medicine, Bachelor of Surgery, Redin Ahmad. Sumra Ahmed. Wynette Akobir. Rohit Banwait. Alice Barrett. Adam Bennett. Harriet Berry. Cara Bryan. Emily Broad. Claire Brunning. Alexandra Buckle. Alexander Collins. Samuel Couch. Also awarded the Most Improved Overall Performance Prize, Rupert Cunnington. Blanid Dehan. Hannah Delmas. Mark Doyle. Also awarded the Best Elective Proposal Prize, Miles Edwards. Gareth Francis. Alice Glacier. Georgina Gregory. Emily Hale. Philip Hamilton. Charlotte Hart. Neha Hadrali. Amy Hooper. Christina Humpleby. Lewis Hutchinson. Atia Islam. Rukmini Jagdish. Matthew Judd. Sammy Casto. Also awarded the British Pharmacological Society Prize, Gabriella Copernica. Matthew Quay. Also awarded the Best Elective Proposal Prize, Abigail Lewis. Michael Lolly. Neil Marshall. Isabel Martin. Maria McHale. Mark Mills. Jonathan Murphy. Yu Jong Nam. Alexander Naylor. Rebecca Nichols. Rose Anne Nuno. Also awarded the Peninsula Award Year 5 and the Medical Knowledge Prize Year 5, Temideo Osu Ranobi. Matthew Owen. Amber Pankhurst. Sarah Redmond. Samuel Richards. Beatrice Robertson-Jones. Imran Ralph. Alexandra Sloan. Chetan Sudarshan. Tirajet Teachmenakeethichai. Isabel Tucker. Luke Tyler. Ahmed Umar. Rashmi Varadasu. James Vaz. Anna Wilkins. Alicia Wong. James Woolis. That concludes the student awards for Bachelor of Medicine, Bachelor of Surgery, and we now move on to the Doctor's Declaration. Reciting the declaration in public is voluntary, but it can help give our graduates the realisation that they are entering a noble and trusted profession which places patients at the centre of their working lives. Those Bachelor of Medicine, Bachelor of Surgery students choosing to participate in the Doctor's Declaration, please now stand and turn to the reverse of your blue instructions to graduates sheet, where you will find the declaration. And please read along with me. Now, as a new doctor, I solemnly promise that I will, to the best of my ability, serve humanity, caring for the sick, promoting good health, and alleviating pain and suffering. I recognize that practice of medicine is a privilege with which comes considerable responsibility, and I will not abuse my position. I will practice medicine with integrity, humility, honesty, and compassion, working with my fellow doctors and other colleagues to meet the needs of my patients. I shall never intentionally do or administer anything to the overall harm of my patients. I will not permit considerations of gender, race, religion, political affiliation, sexual orientation, nationality, or social standing to influence my duty of care. I will oppose policies in breach of human rights and will not participate in them. I will strive to change laws that are contrary to my profession's ethics and will work towards a fairer distribution of health resources. I will assist my patients to make informed decisions that coincide with their own values and beliefs and will uphold patient confidentiality. I will recognise the limits of my knowledge and seek to maintain and increase my understanding and skills throughout my professional life. I will acknowledge and try to remedy my own mistakes and honestly assess and respond to those of others. I will seek to promote the advancement of medical knowledge through teaching and research. I make this declaration solemnly, freely, and upon my honour. Deputy Vice-Chancellor, I have the honour of presenting the following students from the Peninsula Medical School. Postgraduate Certificate in Clinical Education, Claire Woodmore. Master of Clinical Education, Louis Fiander. Postgraduate Certificate, Healthcare, Management, Leadership and Innovation, Jenna Richards. Master of Science, Healthcare Management, Leadership and Innovation, Sophie McGlade. Postgraduate Diploma in Physician Associate Studies, Maria Hoskin. Deputy Vice-Chancellor, I have the honour of presenting the following doctorate awards from the Peninsula Medical School. Doctor of Philosophy, having undertaken a programme of research in metagenomic identification and characterisation of emerging and re-emerging viruses causing disease in febrile patients, Emma Wise. Doctor of Philosophy, having undertaken a programme of research in role of myrnome in a meningioma tumours, identification of potential molecular biomarkers and therapeutic targets for high-grade meningioma, Katerina Negroni. I would now like to invite Fazia Ahmed, student representative, to propose the vote of thanks.
Family, friends, honoured guests, teaching and support staff, and graduates. It gives me great honour on behalf of the graduating class of 2020 to be with you in person and deliver the vote of thanks. A recognition of dedication and determination from our time at the University of Plymouth and your life experiences that have followed. The end of our university journey was not what any of us expected or hoped. Well, we have come back together today to finally close this chapter of our lives and say our goodbyes to our classmates and all of the members of staff who supported us along the way. What a journey it has been, individual to each and every one of us. And although we're further along than we thought we would be, it is great to be able to celebrate its conclusion. What we leave behind and what we have taken with us is something we are proud to be part of. The memories we have made, the skills we have learned, the friends we have found, and the places we have seen, and the people we have become. Without a doubt, it is the people here celebrating with us today that have played such important roles in helping us along the way, and how excited we are to see each other again. Thank you to our friends who have become our family, made university feel like a second home, who dragged us in and out of the library when needed, and organized Zoom quizzes to keep in touch when we were apart. For many, today is the first opportunity we've seen each other off of a screen. Thank you to our families who were just at the end of the phone when things weren't going to plan or sent us money when we were running short. We are all so grateful to you for letting us move back in with you at a moment's notice. Thank you to all members of staff who have inspired us, challenged us, and supported us. For many, you are the reason we persevered during difficult times and one of the biggest draws to coming back today. On behalf of the University of Plymouth Students' Union, we would like to congratulate all graduates and thank individuals for their contributions. Thank you to those who came and made the Students' Union their home, whether it was endless coffees during exams and deadlines or a celebration after handing. Thank you for sharing your moments with the SU. Our university life gave us the chance to participate in new things, find friends for life, and grow as individuals. Many of us did not get to experience our last sports fixture, our last society social, or our last organized fundraiser, but do not let this overshadow the incredible experiences you have gained and made you who you are today. Thank you to those who represented the student body as a course rep, school rep, or as a part-time officer. And of course, thank you to those who signed petitions, led on campaigns, and fought for positive change in our community. Student voices are powerful, and your voice has been heard today by the very fact that we are formally celebrating today and finally getting our obligatory photo in front of Smeaton's Tower. As we come to the end, take a moment to reflect on your university experience and to look back on how far you have progressed in the past 2 years. We have had the unique opportunity to sit beside people with different opinions and different languages, but all with the same ambition to achieve something great. And as you continue to aspire for more greatness in this ever-changing world, I encourage you to be as brave as you were on your first year at university and as resilient as those times you thought you couldn't do it, and remind yourself of just how much you have achieved. You are leaders, You are teachers and you are carers, and you are so much more than when you left. I will now leave you with a quote from Viola Davis. All dreams are within reach. All you have to do is to keep moving towards them. On behalf of the University of Plymouth Students Union and the Sabbatical Officer team, we wish you all the very best. Enjoy your evening, class of 2022. I will now hand over to Professor Subi Banerjee to close the ceremony. Thank you.
Thank you, Fawzi. It's been my very great privilege and pleasure this afternoon to congratulate each and every one of you as you've made your way across this stage, and congratulate you again for doing something which only you know, walking and trying to touch the brim of headgear that actually hasn't got a brim is quite difficult, especially in front of about 1,000 other people. So congratulations for that as well. So we celebrate that achievement, and of course the achievement of your qualification, your time at Plymouth. So this is a very special day. It's a day that celebrates the award of your qualification and gives you a chance to remember the time you spent with us. All graduation ceremonies are important and joyous occasions for the university because they symbolize the academic achievement and hard work that brings you to this moment in time. But this is an occasion with a difference, one that we're honored and delighted to finally be able to welcome you back for. For you, our graduation cohort of 2020, this is a chance to both rewind the clock and think about and embrace both the present, the past, and the future. 2 years ago, as we've heard, the global pandemic forced our ceremonies to be held virtually. And while they offered the university the chance to express its pride in your achievements, you were not able to share the full experience with your class, your friends, and your family. And we're delighted today that you finally get that opportunity. And we hope that it's everything you imagined it would be. Since you completed your studies, you, I know, will have begun new and exciting phases in your lives, and already playing a part in helping the world move forward again. But do take a moment today to reflect upon all you've achieved, both at university and since, and how your degree was made possible with the support of your family and friends in particular. And I join with you in thanking them for that support. Despite the challenges of the last 2 years, your university has continued to look to the future and enjoy great success. And I'm not going to delay you too long, but just a snapshot of what we've been up to since you were last here. In April of this year, we were again recognized as among the world's top universities for our marine excellence and climate action. Our marine scientists and engineers are leading groundbreaking projects, from the installation of the country's first shoreside green energy charging points for maritime vessels to delivering the first national facility focused on maritime cybersecurity research. Our biomedical research is making major breakthroughs in fields such as antibacterial resistance and brain tumours, while our earth and environmental science researchers are leading a project to revolutionise how waste material from construction projects is managed. We're investing in and developing our campus and estate with new facilities focusing on engineering and design, nursing and healthcare, and brain research and imaging. And last, but very much not least, we've also learned that Plymouth has been shortlisted in the University of the Year category in the Times Higher Education Awards for 2022. Please keep your fingers crossed for us. We will know whether we have won in November. I hope that your time at Plymouth has given you a zest to continue learning for life. This will help you realize your aspirations throughout your chosen careers and throughout life more generally. Wherever your journey takes you after graduation, you will always remain a member of our community, our family of alumni, a growing global body of more than 170,000 graduates from over 130 countries. So always remember that this is your university. Let us know what you're up to, how we can help you, and indeed, how you can help us, the university, and future cohorts of students. But whatever path you choose in life, continue to use the skills and abilities you've developed for the benefit of others. Be catalysts, be sparks of positive change in whatever community you choose to live and work in. We hope you will remain as proud of your university as we are of you. So today is a meeting point of past, present, and future. Enjoy it. It's a special day. It's a unique day. May I, on behalf of the university, finally wish you a very successful, but most importantly, happy future. Thank you. Mark, that marks the end of our ceremony, but may I ask guests to remain in the graduation hall until the platform party and the graduates have departed. Our graduates will now process from the marquee for their class of 2020 photograph, which you can view the taking of on the seaward side of the marquee. Those of you who are not of a geographical or nautical bent, or even very observant, that's that way. And then you can join your graduates in the post ceremony reception. So I now formally close this ceremony. Wish you all very happy celebrations for the rest of today. Enjoy your time in Plymouth and have very safe journeys home. If I could please ask everyone to stand.
Today this could be the greatest day of our lives. Before it all ends, before we run out of time, stay close to me, stay close to me. Watch the world come alive tonight. Tonight this could be the greatest night of our lives. Let's make a new start. The future is ours to find. Can you see it? Can you see?
Best. You can be the King Kong banging on your chest. You can beat the world, you can win the war. You can talk to God, cold banging on his door. You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock. You can move a mountain, you can break rocks. Some will call it practice, some will call it luck. But either way, you're going to the history books. Standing in the Hall of Fame, and the world's gonna know your name. You can run the mile, you can walk straight through hell with a smile. You can be a hero, you can get the gold. Breaking all the records they thought would never be broke. Yeah, do it for your people, do it for your pride. Are you ever gonna know if you never even try? Do it for your country, do it for your name. Cause there's gonna be a day when you're standing in the Hall of Fame. And the world. Politicians be preachers, yeah. Be believers, be leaders, be astronauts, be champions, be truth seekers, be students, be teachers, be politicians, be preachers, yeah. Be believers, be leaders, be astronauts, be champions. Standing in the Hall of Fame, and the world's gonna know your name. You can break.
wax. Someone come and practice, someone come and look.
Because I'm happy,
clap along if you feel like that's what you want.